After the recent driver updates, Intel's Arc A770 and A750 GPUs have been getting a lot of positive buzz, especially in the gaming community. Gamers Nexus and tech testers have done an excellent job showcasing the improvements in gaming performance of these GPUs since the new driver release. However, I have not seen a single video discussing the performance of these GPUs when it comes to content creation workloads, especially video editing. So in today's video, I am going to compare the video editing performance of Intel Arc A770 and Arc A750 with NVIDIA's RTX 3060 GPU in two popular video editing softwares, DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Premiere Pro. So whether you are a content creator looking to upgrade your setup, or if you are just someone who is curious about the capabilities of these GPUs in video editing, make sure that you watch this video till the end. This video is brought to you by scdkey.com, where you can purchase Windows 10 Pro OEM keys for only $15.77. Use the link in the video description below to purchase Windows 10 Pro or Windows 10 Home OEM keys, and don't forget to use my 25% coupon code TP25. To activate your Windows license, press and hold Windows key plus S and type activation settings in the search box. Next, click on change product key at the bottom of the page and paste your newly purchased Windows 10 Pro OEM key. Wait for a few minutes and boom, your Windows 10 Pro is now fully activated. And by the way, you can always upgrade to Windows 11 Pro for free. You can also get Microsoft Office 2019 and various other PC games. So check the links that I've put in the video description below. And now let's get back to the video. Intel officially entered the discrete graphics market with the launch of their 16GB Arc A770 and 8GB Arc A750 GPU. These GPUs have been creating some buzz after Intel dropped the price on the A750, which can now be purchased for under $250. Meanwhile, the flagship Arc A770 is selling for around $350, which is in line with the 12GB version of NVIDIA's RTX 3060, and that goes for around $360. But the real question is, how good are these Intel GPUs for content creation at this price point? Now on paper, both these cards look like a great solution for content creators. Intel has been touting their new technology called Deep Link and Hyper Encode. Intel claims that these new technologies significantly increase the video editing capability of Arc A770 and A750. So what exactly is Deep Link and what exactly is Hyper Encode? Well, Hyper Encode allows for faster video encoding by utilizing multiple media engines working in parallel on Intel platform. This means that if you have a 12th or a 13th generation Intel CPU with integrated graphics, and if you pair it with an Intel Arc A770 or A750, you will see improved video encoding performance. The reason for this is that Hyper Encode technology will simultaneously use all the media engines that are present in the discrete as well as the integrated graphics. However, not all software in the market today support this technology. So at the time of making this video, only Handbrake, Magix Video Pro, and DaVinci Resolve Studio Edition, only these three softwares supported this technology. Now, if you're wondering about Adobe Premiere, then as usual, it is a bit behind and currently it does not support this feature. Here is a chart that compares the ProRes to H.264 encoding performance of the 16GB Intel Arc A770, 8GB Arc A750, and 12GB RTX 3060 in DaVinci Resolve Studio Edition. I have set the RTX 3060 performance as the baseline with a relative score of 100%. So any card that performs faster than the RTX 3060 will score over 100%. And anything slower than RTX 3060 will get a score of less than 100%. So if you take a closer look at this chart, you will see that I have broken down the performance of the Intel cards into two categories. There is Hyper Encode enabled, and then there is Hyper Encode not enabled. Now for both these scenarios, the Intel Arc GPUs were paired with an Intel Core i9-12900K processor, which comes with its own integrated GPU. Now, when paired with any 12th or 13th gen Intel CPU, Hyper Encode is enabled by default in DaVinci Resolve. However, to disable Hyper Encode, you need to go in the BIOS and disable the iGPU. So here is the rundown of the results. When Hyper Encode was enabled, the 16GB Intel Arc A770 outperformed the NVIDIA RTX 3060 by a remarkable 47%. However, when hyperencode was turned off, both cards were quite evenly matched, with the Intel Arc A770 just barely edging out by about 3%. Now, it's worth noting that both the RTX 3060 and Intel Arc A770, they both are priced at around $350, making the Intel card a much better value for video encoding, especially if your system is already running on a 12th or a 13th gen Intel CPU with integrated graphics. But what I found even more surprising was the performance of the less expensive $250 Intel Arc A750. With hyperencode enabled, this card outperformed the much pricier RTX 3060 by 12%. But without hyperencode enabled, Arc A750 was 11% slower than RTX 3060. So if your workstation is running on a 12th or a 13th gen Intel chip, the Intel Arc GPUs are far superior for video encoding compared to NVIDIA RTX 3060. But if you have an AMD Ryzen system or an older Intel CPU, then the RTX 3060 may be a better choice for you. Okay, now let's move on and examine the H.264 codec video decoding performance in DaVinci Resolve Studio Edition. Now, the H.264 codec is widely used by most consumer level cameras, including the Sony A6400 camera that I'm currently using to record this video. Now, it's crucial that your GPU is capable of hardware decoding all popular codecs. If not, the video decoding will be handled by the CPU, and that will lead to a very choppy and stuttery timeline playback. This is something no video editor wants to deal with, especially since they often spend a lot of time playing and replaying the video in your timeline. So the last thing you want is a stuttery, choppy playback. Okay, so let's take a look at the results for H.264 to DNX HR high quality decoding performance. When hyperencode is enabled, the Intel Arc A770 is 8% slower compared to RTX 3060, and the Arc A750 lags behind by about 10%. However, with hyperencode disabled, both Intel GPUs don't perform as well and they fall behind the RTX 3060 by a significant 23% margin. So this makes it evident that NVIDIA's hardware decoders are still the top choice for video decoding. Now, this really comes as no surprise because NVIDIA cards are known for their reliable and sturdy hardware decoders. And this is one of the main reasons why YouTubers, streamers, and content creators, they always prefer NVIDIA cards over AMD and Intel. Next, let's take a look at the GPU effects. So this evaluation will assess the effectiveness of features such as color grading and advanced fusion effects in DaVinci Resolve. As you can see in this chart, the NVIDIA RTX 3060 is 10% faster than the Arc A770 and 17% faster than the Arc A750. Now, this outcome does not surprise me, as NVIDIA's CUDA cores are a recognized standard in the industry and they excel in executing advanced effects in DaVinci Resolve. And again, this is why many professionals trust NVIDIA cards over all the other options. Next, let's examine the handling of RED and BRAW footage by these GPUs. Although not everyone utilizes these codecs, I am aware that serious video editors and filmmakers frequently use them. Unfortunately, Intel card lags behind when it comes to deburring and processing RAW footage. In terms of RED BRAW media, the RTX 3060 outpaces both Intel Arc A770 and A750 by over 30%. These results clearly indicate that Intel needs to improve in many GPU accelerated tasks in DaVinci Resolve. Hopefully Blackmagic, who are the creators of DaVinci Resolve software, they and Intel come together, they collaborate if they are not already collaborating, and they fix this issue. Finally, let's take a look at the standard overall DaVinci Resolve score. So this score represents the overall performance across a range of workflows in DaVinci Resolve. RTX 3060 comes out ahead, beating Arc A770 by 18% and Arc A750 by 23%. So here is the bottom line when it comes to DaVinci Resolve. While Intel Arc GPUs performed well in H.264 encoding task, they lagged behind the NVIDIA GPU in other workflows. Hence, if you are a content creator using DaVinci Resolve, the NVIDIA RTX 3060 remains the better choice. Okay, but what about the performance of Intel Arc GPUs in Adobe Premiere Pro? Now, this is a software which is widely used by video editors, and this is considered as an industry standard. Most video editors, they prefer Adobe over DaVinci Resolve. I am the exception. I like DaVinci Resolve, but I know a lot of you guys actually use Adobe. Now, unlike DaVinci Resolve, Adobe Premiere Pro does not officially support the hyper-encode feature in Intel Arc GPU. Instead, it relies more on the CPU cores that are present in your CPU. Nonetheless, in H.264 and HEVC video playback, both Intel A770 and A750 outperformed the NVIDIA RTX 3060 by about 7%. However, NVIDIA takes the lead in ProRes playback, outpacing A770 by 8% and A750 by 11%. Similarly, in Red Raw codec playback, the RTX 3060 outpaces the Intel cards by a significant margin, surpassing both of them by over 27%. Now, in the overall GPU effects, the NVIDIA RTX 3060 outpaced the Arc A770 by 6% and A750 by 11%. Finally, in the Adobe Premiere Pro overall extended benchmark, RTX 3060 narrowly beat both Intel GPUs by about 3%. So these results prove that when you are using Adobe software, the performance difference between NVIDIA GPUs and Intel GPUs is not that significant, nothing close to what you saw with DaVinci Resolve. Okay, next I want to talk about Blender. So Blender is one of the few rendering engines on the market that currently supports Intel GPUs. Unfortunately, both the Arc A770 and A750, they lag behind the NVIDIA RTX 3060 by a whopping 33% in this test. Honestly, the results are so bad for Intel that any competition in this space would be a welcome change. I really don't want NVIDIA to monopolize the 3D animation market, so I would like to see AMD and Intel step up. So there you have it. NVIDIA is still the champion when it comes to content creation workloads. I am glad that Intel is bringing some new competition in this field, but they still need to step up their game if they want to seriously challenge NVIDIA. Hopefully, Battlemage and Celestial, the next generation Intel Arc GPUs, will do a better job. So until then, if you are in the market for a GPU for video editing and content creation, you will have to settle with NVIDIA. In my opinion, the 12GB model of RTX 3060, it is a pretty good entry-level GPU for 1080p and even 4K content creation. But if you want something better and if you are willing to spend some more money, then I would recommend going with RTX 4070 Ti. And this is largely because this GPU uses the new Ada Lovelace architecture and it comes with double the media encoders. In fact, RTX 4070 Ti uses the same video encoders and the same video decoders that you find in the flagship RTX 4090. On the other hand, if you are waiting for RTX 4060 Ti and if you are wondering what kind of performance that card would offer, then check out this video over here. In this video, I discuss everything that we know about the upcoming RTX 4060 Ti GPU. So go ahead and watch that video, and I will see you guys over there. Bye!